Their country, Kazakhstan, is the largest in Central Asia. Yet only about 17 million people inhabit its 2.7 million square kilometers. Traditional Kazakhs value their extended families of grandparents, aunts, uncles, and cousins. In the evenings, they gather for tea and conversation. Kazakhs who live in urban areas are considerably more Western than those in the villages. An estimated 40% of the Kazakhs live in cities, where they mingle with multitudes of other ethnic groups that form the diverse population of Kazakhstan. During the 18th century, the Kazakhs were dominated by their powerful northern neighbor, Russia. The communist revolution in the early 20th century made Kazakhstan a republic of the Soviet Union and brought an end to the Kazakhs' nomadic ways.
The Russians came and cultivated our land and made us live in one place. Kazakh schools were closed and everything became Russified.
With the collapse of the Soviet Union in 1991, Kazakhstan declared itself an independent country. Though welcoming the freedom, many find life is more difficult now. Throughout the country, unemployment, inflation, and rampant corruption have led to enormous economic problems. A university professor who's a chemical engineer now sells toothpaste in a local market.
The main thing for me is how to get enough money to feed my family.
Many Kazakhs use alcohol to escape from their problems. This talented young man was one.
When people drink, they forget everything, at least for one day. But in the morning, they have to drink again. That's how I became an alcoholic.
Disillusioned, confused, and struggling to survive, many Kazakhs are seeking truth on which to base their lives. Though some people are looking to their Islamic heritage, thousands of Kazakhs have discovered the truth in Jesus Christ.
On my knees, I prayed and cried for Jesus, and he saved me by his power. I cannot even describe how he delivered me from alcoholism. It was a miracle by God's grace.
Now is the time for the Kazakhs. The nation stands on the brink of a massive movement to spread the gospel from family to family and village to village. If response continues at the present rate, a nation which until recently was totally unreached may soon see the gospel proclaimed throughout the land. Pray that the window of opportunity for the gospel will remain open.